Viper's probably the coolest character, and the reason for that is Viper's the one that I think the first person to befriend Poe.
Yes.
Do you not agree?
She does become the more open animal towards him because he's sort of being shunned by the Furious Five in the beginning. And I think it's nice to know that they're trying to work against the idea of a cold-blooded snake and sort of warm her up with him.
So the phone call. Lucy, we got an animated character we want you to do. It's a snake. What's your first thought?
Fantastic. I mean, they didn't call me and say that, actually.
In my mind, they did.
Can you imagine? Let me rearrange your mind for a minute.
Okay, tell me how
they called me
works.
And said, hey, we have this idea for this movie, but we right. want you to come in and we want to talk to you about it.
Okay.
Curious. So curiosity seeps in. And then I go in and they have this room filled with drawings of like all of the things that they're thinking about doing. You get totally sucked into it. And then they show you what character they want you to play. And you're like, whoa. And then they show you a little bit of on the computer about her movements and how she's going to kind of fight. It was amazing.
Yeah, so there's never like, there's this praying mantis, and you're like, snake, actually. You know, they know what they want.
They have that idea in their mind.
They, in their mind, they have snake, they have your voice, because they know you. So, but you're like, okay, this is a voice job. Do you, like, try to play with your voice or try to come up with a...
Absolutely. You go in there, and you're like, great, I can, you know, sound like, you know... I have a southern accent or something, and who knows what you want. But they actually played with different things, and they found that what they wanted was more of a normal voice, and they wanted to work with all the other characters and all the other actors on that same level, too.
It's the best part of doing voiceover work, the fact that you don't have to spend hours in makeup or dress, you know.
Hours? Kidding.
No, I mean, what?
17 to be precise. I started yesterday.
Not that you need any makeup.
I mean, no. We all need a little something. Yeah. I mean, I think the best part about it is how casual it is, but how intense the process is, you know? And it's something that you're part of this program that's been started, you know, 5 years ago, and it's still going on, and it's still going on, and then suddenly it comes out, and you can't even believe it. I mean, I feel like I haven't really even done enough for this movie because I'm... It's such a phenomenal result. You know, the end result of it is like so fabulous. Mm. And I just, I don't know. I like doing that. I like being a part of something on that long-term basis, you know?
Is there any weight put behind it, the fact that it is a family film and a good one at that?
I think they automatically think animated equals family film. But the fact that it's great, I mean, you always hope that it's going to be great. You don't really know how people are going to receive it. I'm really proud of it. I'm proud of being in it, and I think that's the most important thing. If you feel really great about your work, you know, sometimes things, you know, succeed or fail. You don't know why. The weather changes. Who knows what's going on? But based on this, it's something that no matter what, I really feel great about it, and I think that's the most important thing, that you feel like you're proud of something that you did.
Yeah, it's a very good film. I mean, there's some genuinely hysterical laughs in this movie.
Hysterical.
Yeah.
What was your favorite moment?
You know, I'm, of course, a big fan of the Poe Meister. I want a Poe doll.
Skadoo.
Like, you know, yeah, exactly. You know, just because it's almost like you saw Jack Black.
His soul was in the character.
No, but when you're doing a snake, though, I mean, it's just like, sometimes you always hear, like, they're filming you or they're trying to get your mannerisms, but there's not much they can do with the snake, is there? I mean,
well, actually, did you know the snake was the most challenging character in the movie to do?
No, I did not.
Like, they have trademarked the snake's movements in this movie because it's never been done before, and they actually called people in from MIT, professors, to like come in and confer about this snake character. So the snake actually was the most difficult thing to do because it had no limbs, and they basically said the skeleton was a tube, and how are they going to animate this tube to make it move like a snake and fight and be warm? And I found this out, you know, just recently, and I was like, really? I had no idea. So it's kind of fascinating.
Absolute pleasure.
You too.
Thank you.